If you're in the other room, come take a look at this. They're beautiful, they're hardy, and if you lived and grew up in a place like Kaimuki, they seem to be everywhere. But what are they? Cactuses? Succulents? Well, the man who knows all, Rod Oshima from Diamondhead Plants. Aloha, Rod. You know, and that's the thing. Cactuses, succulents, what's the difference right there?
Well, all cactuses are succulents, but all succulents are not cactus.
That's a tongue twister right there. But they're so beautiful, and you know, I mean, just amazing the variety. But what are some of the variables? What's important to make them looking good and keeping them nice and fresh and well growing? Well,
number one, they need a lot of sunlight.
Okay.
And number two, good drainage. And so air circulation is very important.
I see. And when you're saying drainage, I mean, it's kind of like this right here. You know, the water can get through. It's like a gravel type of medium, right?
So when you pour water in, it should drain right through.
Wow.
Because, you know, they grew up in deserts. Or a good example is orchids. Orchids are succulents, too.
Oh,
and they grew up
that.
In trees.
Oh.
So, you know, I
That's
mean...
That's the drainage and stuff.
Exactly.
Oh. And, you know, Kaimuki, plenty of sunlight over there. I grew up on Ocean View Drive, and we had all these at my neighbor's house. But why do you think they are so popular, especially here in drier parts, Hawaii, Ewa side?
Right, because of water conservation is important. You know, a lot of people don't have the time to really take care of an orchid. But, you know, succulents, you just make sure it's moist, fertilized once a month maybe.
Wow.
That's about it.
That's it. And again, so beautiful. And again, for a guy like me, low maintenance is key. Now, you know, I love you because you're a wealth of knowledge. Anytime I have any questions about any type of plant or trees or anything like that, you're the one to talk to. Mm-hmm. But anybody out there, I heard you're going to be doing some kind of classes, right?
Yes, first weekend of each month, Saturday, we're going to be having classes. For example, March 4th, we're going to be having a succulent class. So for a price of less than $50, you can come in, get a plant, three plants actually.
Wow.
A planner, the media, and we'll show you how to construct
some of these. Well, I mean, that's really cool because I'm going to say, when you talk about the, I mean, there's, I'm just looking at these things, how different the varieties are. So having a class like that and knowing how to put it in the right pot and meaning is going to be very important. I got to ask, what are some of these? I mean, these are more cactus style. What are some of these, if you can say?
Well, if you look at this, this is a euphorbia. You can see that the thorns are actually part of, is a leaf.
Yeah, it's a thorns and then it grows up into the leaf
right
there.
Yeah, so, you know, actually the leaves are... become a thorn.
Oh, it goes that way. Yeah. I understand. Yeah. And yeah, what are some of these other ones here?
Well, this one is very unique because it's a Hawaiian succulent, one of the few.
Wow.
It's called Portulaca molokiniensis.
That's beautiful. And you know, I always love that too. You know, in Hawaii, we like to use plants that are native to here. And again, something that's home and, well, absolutely beautiful. Go ahead.
And it does have a nice, long, bright yellow inflorescence or flower.
It comes out.
Yeah.
Wow.
So that's a plus.
That is a plus. And then any of these other ones here, I mean, gosh, they're so beautiful. This is almost like, it looks like a rose, but still a succulent, huh?
Right. They're all succulents.
Wow. You know, I also love, too, we were talking about this before, I got a lot of people asking about those wonderful pitcher plants you were talking about. And again, when it comes to the classes and things like that, people can still call and get those from
you,
right?
Oh, yeah. We have a good supply now, and they're grown, so they're good sizes.
Yeah, and those are great too. I got to be honest with you, very easy to take care of. I got it in my backyard, but they also take care of those flies. I don't have any problems with that or any kind of the insects in the back area. All right, thank you so much for showing me these things because, again, they're beautiful, and then some of them, they're native Hawaii. It's just nice to know that, well, we have you as an expert in those classes. They're great. Mahalo, bro. Thank you so much. And again, we'll have all the information on our website as well. You got to sign up for those classes. It's such a great deal. Diamond Head Plants are the way to go.